Belgium have been patient when it comes to the Davis Cup. They've never won the title and have waited more than 100 years for the chance to win it.
Say action.
Action. Belgium is my home.
Belgium is my home.
Belgium is my home. We are, j'ai pas vu la fin, wait, excuse me. We are best known, okay.
We are best known for our
chocolates, diamonds.
And diplomacy.
And diplomacy.
When it comes
to sports,
we have a strong national football team.
And two tennis legends, Kim Clijsters and Justine Henin.
Now, it's the men's turn to make Davis Cup history.
David Goffin
and Steve Darcy will lead the team.
I never expected that one day I would cover a Davis Cup final with a Belgian team in it, to be honest. It's, of course, a massive surprise. We have a very, very good team in the way that we have two very good singles players. David, who's risen like a rocket last year and is now in the top 20, even in the top 15. Steve, who's a real Davis Cup player. For him, it's something he's probably hoped all his life to be in. And he made it happen, so it's fantastic for him.
The atmosphere was unbelievable in this stadium. It's so famous in Belgium, and yeah, for our small country, I think it's pretty big.
Davis Cup can either transcend people, you know, make them rise above what they are, lift them up, but it can also, with the pressure, it can make them break down. And with Steve, it's always been uplifting. He plays out of his mind sometimes. And in Belgium, we call him Mr. Davis Cup. David is the better player from the two. We saw it coming perhaps in 2012, you know, when he played his first Grand Slam at Roland Garros, won his first three matches, and then played that amazing fourth round against Roger Federer, and then finally lost in four after having played great and receiving all the congratulations of the master himself.
My job was to bring my point today, and that's what I did. I had to just to focus on what I had to do, on my job, and that's what I did.
At that time, we thought, oh, yeah, we have a future great player. And then suddenly, yeah, he had a click in his mind, perhaps, and he started an amazing series of wins, you know, 44 out of 48. And since then, yeah, I mean, he's passed, I wouldn't say one level, but perhaps five levels, and now he kind of feels at home in that top 20.
It was a tough one. The atmosphere is amazing here in Brussels.
The odds are honestly a little more in favor of the Brits. I know people always want to have percentages, which is it's really difficult in sports because it's not an exact science. But I would say 40% for us, 60% for the Brits, if Andy Murray is in good shape, because of course he's going to have to play three matches and he's going to have to win his three matches.